Hi, my name is Yuri Fedotov. I am the executive director of the United Nations Office on Drugs and Crime, which has been working against human trafficking since 1999. Criminals are very good in taking advantage of people who are searching for a better life, exploiting their dreams and vulnerabilities. It's especially true in less developed countries and countries emerging from conflict or natural disaster, but it can happen everywhere. As a guardian of the United Nations Protocol to prevent, suppress, and punish trafficking in persons, UNODC helps member states draft laws and create comprehensive anti-trafficking strategies. We offer specialized assistance, experience, and practical tools to encourage national action and cross-border cooperation in investigating and prosecuting traffickers. No part of our planet is immune to trafficking in persons. Almost every nation in the world is affected by this horrific crime against human dignity, whether it's a country of origin, transit, or destination for victims. Right now, some 2.5 million women, children, and men around the world are being exploited by criminals like slaves. They have been trafficked into forced labor, sexual exploitation, domestic servitude, forced marriage, and even organ removals. Children, who accounts for 21% of human trafficking victims, are vulnerable to exploitation for begging, domestic servitude, the sex trade, and as a child soldiers. But luckily, there is a growing awareness of human trafficking. More and more governments, civil society groups, international organizations, and private sector businesses are working to stop this deeply abusive and degrading practice. But much needs to be done. We must do more to prevent criminals from exploiting fellow human beings, to protect the victims of this crime, to prosecute traffickers, and to empower victims. Criminals around the globe have the power to stop trafficking in persons. They can prevent human trafficking by informing their members about this crime and protecting them from the risk of exploitation. They can also gather information that can help authorities to go after traffickers, and they can help survivors reintegrate into society and find employment. Communities can play an especially important role around the organization of the London Olympic Games, since traffickers often try to take advantage of big international events to lure individuals into exploitation. I would like to thank all participants in this event for your efforts to stop human trafficking. UNODC is honored to have a long-standing cooperative relationship with Stop the Traffic through UN GIFT, and we look forward to continue working with you around the Olympic Games. Thank you.